equal to 1.2. Now, if I take the previous question, that's the 14th question. The 14th question, we were, I think, this may be evaluated I and then. So this, in this case, if I take x equal to p, because this we have already calculated, one minus x, p, here q is 1.2, okay, and n is 5 by 2. Let me take this then, in that way. That will be calculated from this question. So if I solve it that way, it can be then calculated. Okay, this question was this one. When I n minus 1 was, when the n minus 1 power was written there, and x to the power p was there. Okay, that let me calculate. So finally, n q into I n. Okay, but 0 to 1 limits are there, 0 to 1 limits are here. Okay, but let me compare this with 14th question. With 14th question number. In 14th question, we have in question number 14th. Question 14, we have same question here. X is for p by there, p is minus 1.4, we substitute, and q is half, and this n is 5 by 2. Let me take that. That will be what's in this one. We have I n is equal to I n was n q divided by n q plus p plus 1. Into I n minus 1. This was the question. Okay, this evaluation is there. Evaluate. Yes. I n. And this value is given. Okay, this is my question. This is based on the same thing. Here, we can substitute. We see here the question is same. This is what? 0 to 1 I n is x to the power p. 1 minus x to the power q. 1 power p. Well, this was n only, I'm sorry. Here it was n into dx. So this was given to us n cube, divided by n cube, plus p plus 1, sine of 0, 0, 1. This is x to the power p, into 1 minus x cube, whole power n minus 1, into dx. This is the question given. If I just compare this question with this, okay, we have the same thing we have. So here, putting now in this result, putting here, p is equal to minus 1.4. You see here. Now q is equal to half. Q is equal to half. N is equal to 5 by 2. So what do we get here? Let me calculate this. Therefore, okay. I'm feeling something. Okay. Now let me take here. For question number 14th, from this result, let me write here. So finally, what do we get? This question is that n is 5 by 2, 5.2, n is q is 1.2, divided by n cube, n is 5 by 2, q is 1.2, plus p is minus 1.4. plus 1, 0 to 1, x is again minus 1.4, into 1 minus x, half, whole power, n minus 1 is 3 by 2, and 3 by 2, into dx. Now again, the value we have to find out, by putting n equal to 3 by 2. So when you first let me calculate, what is this value? This value will be, okay, that we have to prove. Okay, up to 1 minus 2, that means up 3 by 2, the next, I have to substitute. After that, we will get the same thing. Okay, no problem at all. Now what is the next value? Let me write here. This we have substituted. Then we have obtained this. That I have just calculated, but before that let me calculate. What is this value? Therefore, 0 to 1, x to the power minus 1.4, 1 minus x to the power half, 1 power 3y to dx, equal putting here. Okay, what will you put in x? P equal to, P equal to minus 1.4, P, and Q again, half. But n is equal to 3. This is the only difference. Here it was 5 by 2, n equal to, but in this case it is 3 by 2. So value will be n into 2, 3 by 2 into 1.2, q is half, here, divided by, again n cube means 3 by 2 into 1.2, minus 1.4 plus 1, p is still minus 1.4, 0 to 1, actually for minus 1.4. 1 minus x cube, q is half, sorry, q is half, and this is 3 by 2 minus 1 means 1.2 into dx. This value is obtained. This result is obtained, but before that, this how 5 by 6, 16 have come up, have been calculated now. First, let me solve this. What is this value? So here it is. 3 by 2 means 3 by 4 in the numerator. The numerator what did you get? 3 upon 4 minus 1 upon 4, 2 by 4. It is 2 by 4 plus 1. Okay, into the same thing. Let me first find out this numerical value. 3 upon 4 upon 2 upon 4. Because 3 by 3 minus 1, 2 upon 4. 2 upon 4 is 1 upon 2, 1 and a half. 1 upon 2 and 1, that means 3 by 2. 3, 3 cancel out. Then 2 upon 4. Then 1 upon 2. Which means this answer is 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 is this value. Okay, so this value is 1 upon 2. Let me write here. Finally, 1 upon 2. Into this. In place of this, if I write this value, before that let me cancel this. This is 5 by 4 in the numerator. Divided by 5 by 4 minus 1.4, 4 by 4 that is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. This is 5 by 4 minus 1.4. 5 minus 1 is 4. 4 upon 4. 1. 1 plus 1. 2. That means 5 upon 8 here. 5 upon 8. Into 1.2, 5.16. All right. Same thing has come. Same thing has come out. This is 5.16, 5.87. Now 5.8. Now this value has come out as 1.2 into this. In place of this one, let me substitute here. This is nothing but 5.8 into 1.2. 0 to 1. This x raised to the power minus half was 1.4 into 1 minus x raised to the power half whole power 1.2 into dx. What do you see here? This is the same result as 14. This is 5.16 0 to 1 x raised to the power minus 1.4 1 minus x half whole power half dx. Same result is obtained. We have proved this. We can prove that this is equal to this. We have hence proved. Hence proved. This is the result of 14th. In the result of 14th. As they are given there, as IN is, find IN, evaluate IN when N is a positive integer. So IN, where N is positive integer. Well, it is not integer here because 5 by 2 is not integer. So just we have calculated from the 14th question of 16 that we talked about. Question number 16 is not principal. 15 this time. Okay, now in place of n we can take a numerical value. can also be taken a numerical then. So what is the question number? 16. Then we take that also. Let me clean this. No, question number 16, the last one. What does it say? Question number 16 is, isn't it IN denotes, IN is a plan of integration, dx upon, this is a square, plus f square, whole power n, okay, the whole power n, where is the positive integer? Where n is a positive integer, let me write here positive integer. This is plus sign positive integer. Plus integer, positive integer. Then prove that where n is a positive integer, prove that I n is a prove here, I n is a. This is x upon, okay, 2n minus 2 into a square, denominator into a square plus x square, whole power n minus 1, okay, plus second is twice n minus 3 upon 2n minus 2. Into b square y n minus 1. Okay, that is I n minus 1. Okay. And from this is I n, it means this value is I n of I n. Over it I n minus 2. Okay, now let me take this value. Here I n is this, therefore I n minus 1 will be n minus 1 power here. That is there. No problem. Now let me take this. So here I n is there. Let me write this as a square plus f square whole power minus n. Okay. Minus n here. If I write x raised to 0 into dx, then no problem. This can be written like this. So now comparing to connecting, let me connect. Connecting two integrals. What is two integrals? Connecting two integrals. That is, sign of integration x equals 0, a square plus x square, whole power minus n dx, dx n in sign of integration x equals 0, a square plus x square whole power minus n plus. Okay, this value we have. But which value is greater? This is smaller here, minus n. Minus n plus 1, this is minus n. That means that will be. And if I add here plus 1, it's minus n, smaller is minus n here. That will be greater than power. Now let me take this. Therefore, let s equal to, on comparison, s equal to, let me take x raised power alpha plus 1 into a square plus x square whole power beta plus 1. On comparison of powers, on comparison of powers or indices, so alpha is equal to 0 here, but this is 0, 0 power. So alpha is equal to 0, but this 0 x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, here x is equal to alpha. We compare alpha equal to 0, we will take. here it is minus n, this is minus n, plus 1 I have taken, because this will be in the denominator n minus 1 power. Here it is minus n, this n here. If I take the denominator, it will be minus n plus 1. That value is smaller 1. Okay, so if it is 1 minus n, this is 1 minus n, 1 minus n, this is minus n. No, smaller value is minus n. Beta is from beta point is minus n. So that power is added up. Minus n plus n. So we take minus n. So then here we have to substitute. This will be actually for 1 only, that means 1. Since alpha 0 plus 1 is only 1, it means x only, t square plus x here. Whole power beta, beta is minus n plus 1. This is minus n plus 1. Okay, let me differentiate it. One differentiation of this, let me write it here. Differentiating this value. Differentiating in the first term s equal to this. Differentiating first with respect to s, we get ds upon ds equal to first function s as it is, integration of this simply minus n plus 1. So minus n plus 1, no problem. Okay, minus n plus 1, and power will be minus n minus n only. That means this is a square n square whole power minus n only, because minus n plus 1 minus 1 minus n into 5 cents of differentiation of this again plus sign. Next is x, so differentiation is 1. So it is only a square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1. Now let me separate it. S equal to how much? Okay, let me keep it here. Where S we took, S equal to it was x raised power 0, sorry, x only into k square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1. It was minus n plus 1. Okay, that means x upon a square plus x square 1 minus n minus 1, okay. That will be not a problem. That value is there. Okay. Now let me integrate it, or instead of x into x, x square, it will be 2 into 1 minus n, this value, into x square. X square can be written as x square plus a square minus a square into a square plus x square minus n. Plus sign this value, a square plus x square whole power minus n. Now let me multiply this. It is nothing but 2 into 1 minus n. This value, if I multiply to this, will be a square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1, minus n plus 1, and then minus sign, second part will be minus a square into, this value will be 2 into 1 minus n into a square, and this value same, this is a square plus x square minus n, plus this value a square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1. This minus n plus 1, this value is added up. This is one time, one more. And what it will do? These two values are added up. One gets added, just as you need. 2 minus 2n plus 1. 3 minus 2 minus 3, okay. It is this one. This is th square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1 minus 2 into this value. 2 into 1 minus n into k square. That is a square plus x square whole power minus n. Now this is value of ds of ds. Now if I integrate this, the second equation. Now on integration and transposition, okay, of transposing and integrating. Integration and transposition for transposing, we get on integration of this equation second, we get here, it is s equal, this is 3 minus 2n, 3 minus 2n, in that case it is a sign of integration, d square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1 into dx, this is minus 2 and minus n into a square, then sign of integration is a square plus x square whole power minus n into dx. Now, we have to find out this value in the short term. That means we have to find out this value. If I divide this whole transposing left right here, and S value is there. So let me transpose this function in left hand side. Therefore, on transposing, the last integral to the left, we get this will be positive 2 into 1 minus n into a square sign of integration a square plus x square whole power minus n into s is equal to s will be negative to the side, okay, that will be positive and that's negative minus s here, s is x upon, let me take this in the denominator, a square plus x square whole power n minus 1. Now this will be n negative, sorry, positive n, 1 will be negative value of s. Now this value is also there, this is plus sign 3 minus 2n sign of integration, this is a square plus x square whole power minus n plus 1 ds. Let me write this clear. So what do we get finally? Finally we obtain here, let me now find out this value. Therefore sign of integration a square plus x square whole power minus n into ds is equal to, if I divide by this, minus s of 1, this is 2, okay, 2n minus, if I take positive, if I make it plus sign, it will be 2n minus 2. If I write it 2n minus 2 positive, it will be plus sign, no negative sign there. Negative sign has made it positive, okay, this will also be, if I take positive here also, then it will be 3 minus this minus and this minus are taken. It is 2n minus 3. 2n minus 3 after the minus sign from this and from denominator also this is negative. 2n minus 2 p square. Into sign of integration, this is in minus 1 and this is in minus in only. And so this is in. What that will be? I n is equal to, okay, x upon 2n minus 2 a square, right, saying that this is arbitrary, or that would be faulty. This is e squared plus x squared whole power n minus 1, this n minus 1. Exactly like of this value is also there, this 2n minus 2 a squared in the division, 2n minus 3 in the numerator, and I n minus 1, you write it clearly. I n is equal to x upon 2n minus 2 into a squared, within brackets it is a squared plus x squared, a squared plus x squared, n minus 1, oh, plus this is 2n minus 3 upon 2n minus 2 into a squared, into I n minus 1. What if I write in terms of powers, then it will be sum of integration dx upon what is coming the denominator with positive power n, with positive power n, this divided by this equal to x upon 2n minus 2 into a squared. And bracket is a squared plus x squared whole power n minus 1 plus sign is 2n minus 3 upon 2n minus 2 into a squared sum of integration. This is okay, so 1 upon or dx upon, maybe dx upon power, this will be minus n plus 1, that means a squared plus x squared whole power n minus n bar in the negative, positive in the negative, 1 in the negative, n minus 1 in this. Okay, in other words, this is also that is there finally and so on. And so, this is the final result. I'll write I n minus 1, the I n minus 1 is this value, power of n minus 1. Here it is n power. Same value, 2 and 1 is 2 a squared, with positive negative sign, everything is now given. After this, we have taken some reduction form, we continue. One more lecture there. Upon that, I mean, some more questions are there, and that will be my last series of lectures on the reduction formula. Okay, so see you in the next lecture. In this, I have finalized the complete reduction formula, okay, or formulae, in which the last section is there. So we will discuss in the next lecture the remaining portion of what is the reduction formula continued. That continued portion, the last portion of reduction formula, we are going to follow, we are going to discuss about. That is also very important, because that is in exponential functions, mixture of exponential function, algebraic function, etc. But we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay? See you in the next lecture then. This is complete. This is very important lecture, isn't it? Very good processing. With that, one should understand, only then one can get highest marks in exams like BTEC, okay, engineering classes mostly, BSc college, MSc also, okay, in some of the computer examinations also, this integral calculus is coming. Okay, so all these kind of questions are coming, and this means reduction formula. With the help of reduction formula, we can find out with the repeated use of that formula, which is reduction formula, the final answer. So this is the solution of 16 questions completely. Okay, now in 13th question is IN was here, 14th and 15th. IN was calculated here for 42. Yeah? If any number is taken here in place of N, 2 or 3, then we can apply that 2 or 3 in the same formula which we obtained here. Okay, but here the same value N, P, Q we have taken here, that is just out from each other. Evaluation from 14th question number 50. That will also apply. Okay, now this is over. See you in the next lecture then. Okay.